all those on the standing minutes, so that is that just taken as the cabinet superstatement accepted. Okay, cabinet minute stands. Where
now,
I think we've dealt with the minority reports. We're moving on to item 11, which is notices of motion. It's my understanding for the amendment we moved it early, so you did a long time ago when we moved that. First debate will be devolution to city regions in the name of the Labour Group. There are two amendments to that, as I understand it, is that correct? So we'll take the mover and the movers of the relative amendments and then debate, move to seconders and go to the votes. Is that the correct way to go forward? Okay, so I'll get you to move that bill.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I rise to move the motion on devolution to city regions and local government. Very briefly, I think in the light of the recent Scottish referendum, we do have an unprecedented opportunity in the English regions to make the case for effective devolution, I would argue, to city regions and local government. I think this is underpinned by the principle that decisions are best made about our city region, within the city region, and not by distant ministers and mandarins in Whitehall. This must be, Mr. Mayor, this must be more than the crude English votes for English laws mantra that some are advocating, I believe, for purely party political reasons. And we do have an extremely short window of opportunity over the next 2 months to make this case. Because the government have said that they will publish the bill in January of next year. Now, I believe, Mr. Mayor, we have a ready-made vehicle in the form of the combined authorities to which powers can be devolved. The Liverpool City Region Combined Authority was established in April of this year and is now enshrined in law as a statutory body. I believe our combined authority has already proved its effectiveness in securing £232 million of growth fund money from the government against a total ask of £250 million, an excellent result. And we are working together as a city region in making the case for high-speed rail to be brought directly into Liverpool city centre, into Lime Street, which will benefit the Liverpool city region to the tune of £8 billion in additional gross value added and also some 14,000 jobs. So in making this case, I believe that we must be clear on a number of key issues. First of all, devolution must mean that powers are transferred together with the funding. It just would be a hollow promise if the government merely gave us the responsibility but no funding to carry out those responsibilities. Secondly, I think in terms of areas where it makes eminent sense to ask for more responsibility, it's around issues like transport, infrastructure, skills agenda, strategic sites, housing, and I would also like to see some significant civil service like relocation and the breakup of what I believe is the London-centric civil service administration. There is, Mr. Mayor, a distinctly northern agenda, especially in areas such as transport. And in my role as the chair of the Liverpool City Region, I'm working very closely with the other four combined authorities, which are all in the north, to make this case to government in this short window of opportunity. I'm firmly of the view, Mr. Mayor, that powers and funding should be devolved through the combined authority, and that all combined authorities should be treated equally by government. I do not favour some rumours that I'm hearing that individual combined authorities would be picked off for special treatment. I also want to make clear, Mr. Mayor, that I do not support concentrating powers in the hands of an individual metro mayor. I think that would be a wrong measure. So, Mr. Mayor, this resolution asks for council to support this position, and I've outlined it to ask our four rural MPs to support this stance and assist us with lobbying government on for the simple reason that they seem to have an overwhelming problem with the term Liverpool City Region, but actually, but they prefer the term neighbouring authorities. Actually, it was central government, this government, who insisted that you define what's called a functional economic area, which in our case is the Liverpool City Region. Just calling it neighbouring authorities, I'm afraid, would not pass muster in terms of getting this status. So I simply can't support that. I'm very gratified that they do seem to be trumpeting the Prime Minister's and the Chancellor's conversion to this agenda. I mean, I just have to comment on the side. This government has devolved around $2 billion of funding to the city regions across England. In stark contrast to Lord Heseltine's report, he was arguing for $49 billion to be devolved. So actually, this government, I regard, has failed miserably to devolve substantial powers and responsibilities thus far. However, if they decided that was an incorrect decision, I welcome that conversion. Of course, the other thing just to say is hot news off the press. The Liverpool City Region is clearly so well thought of now that a number of neighbouring authorities are asking if they can join in. So that is something that is allowed in the legislation. And I found out just I think last night, Mr. Mayor, that West Lancashire Council have applied to join the Liverpool City Region. It's permissible within the legislation for neighbouring authorities to join an existing combined authority. So I welcome West Lancashire's request, which I'm sure we will respond positive way to, and I'm aware that a number of other neighbouring authorities in the immediate area are interested in joining the Liverpool city region. I can't support the Tory amendment for those reasons. I will, however, be prepared to accept the Liberal Democrat amendment in the name of Councillor Gilchrist. I think the points he makes in his amendments about the additional powers that the LGA have recommended around things like the work programme, apprenticeships and other funding, I think, around training, I think I would support that being devolved to the city region, to the Liverpool City Region and the combined authority, and also the bringing together of funds in one place. Of course, I do accept the points he makes in the second part of the amendments about decision making